Grind.
And I think
we're
live.
We're live.
All right, so we're going to try this again. So Mix 96 FM, we're hanging out with you here live on The Morning Crew. If you're joining us, we'll wave at the camera. So got a new camera set up. I also got a really fat face camera down here that we're not going to turn on. So
you could
do that to me. I mean, you're the one that has control of it right now. But
it's all right.
But we are here, and we're going to celebrate those birthdays because it is just before 9 o'clock. So as always, Sir Paul, would you do the honors, my friend?
To anybody in the audience who's got a birthday today, happy birthday to you.
That's right. It is that time of day where we check in with the Party Hardy Birthday Patrol, and we let you know who our local celebrities are and who is famous around the world that you might have heard of as well. Famous people like the paper that I lost again.
Uh-oh.
Here we go. Actress Rita Moreno, 92 years old.
I thought she had her birthday
the
other day.
I thought we celebrated her birthday last week, too, but maybe it's today. It's showing up on my list again today.
Maybe
so.
She's got two birthdays.
Maybe there's two Rita Moreno's.
Maybe there are.
Anyway, if it's today or it was last week, she's 92 again. So, Donna Mills.
Yes.
Donna Mills from Knott's Landing is turning 83 today.
Okay.
Remember when Donna Mills and Knott's Landing, when they were the bombshells of the early 80s, of course. Linda Day George from TV's Mission Impossible turning 79 today. Singer Brenda Lee, A Rockin' Around. We just played him in
yes.
The Christmas Tree.
Number one song.
Number one song on Billboard last week.
Yeah.
For the first time in 65 years. Actress Terry Garr turning 76. Remember Terry Garr?
No.
You know her. She was famous in the early 80s. You know those blonde bombshells in the 80s.
I was thinking of what was her name? Jenny Garth.
Jenny Garth, oh yeah.
Yeah. I remember
her. Jermaine Jackson is 69 today.
Oh wait, wrong Jackson. Yeah, it's all
right. Same family, wrong Jackson. He was number four of the five.
That's right.
Nikki Sixx from Motley Crue turning 65 today. Doesn't look a day over 90. Actor Ben Browder from Stargate SG-1 is turning 61. Singer and bassist Justin Curry of Delamitri is 59. Gary Dorden from CSI is 57. Actress and comedian Monique turning 56 today.
Monique.
Yep. Actor Max Martini from The Unit is 54. Ryder Strong from Boy Meets World turning 44 today. Actor Carl Souza from How to Get Away with Murder is 37. And actress and singer Haley Steinfeld turning 27 today. Also, rapper and actor Mos Def.
Mos Def.
Turning 50 years old today. And at that age, he's Mos Def, innately reaching old school status.
That's right.
I thought that was a pretty good joke myself.
It is a good joke.
Anybody you want to shout out today?
We've got a ton today.
All right.
I hate to say one person is more important than others.
Well,
but
I'm going to mention one right off the top of the bat. The legendary Pete Wilson.
Yeah.
Turning 69 years old today. So
Richard Lewis has a birthday today, 66, I believe. Mallory Wilson.
Yes.
She has her birthday today. Katie Peed is a former student of mine from the area, has a birthday as well. And I don't know which one of them it is, so maybe I'll leave this last one alone and you might know it.
All right, Gregory Kaiser celebrating a birthday today. He was a part of our Total Media crew for a while. His birthday is today, and that's all I've got on my list, except for the one that got called in. So.
Okay, well, on yesterday we missed Mike Adams had a birthday yesterday.
Okay.
And Mark Anderson, Mr. A, I know, had a birthday yesterday.
Jason Howell also had a birthday yesterday. Tammy Strange had her birthday yesterday. Amanda Hughes also had a birthday yesterday, too. So I think Adam Davis celebrated the birthday this weekend as well, so happen to see any of those individuals out there, they were celebrating their birthdays this weekend. So, but we did have one called in today, and so we're going to say happy birthday and congratulations today to Katie Jones of Wellston.
All right.
Who's turning 12 years old, and Katie Jones was turned in by Aunt Missy. So happy birthday and congratulations, Katie Jones of Wellston, taking home some cool stuff from our friends at McDonald's of Jackson. And don't forget, if you got a birthday to call in, you are able to get on the list. We'll get your name out there, and we will celebrate with you each and every day right about 9 o'clock here on The Morning Crew. Hey, let's get some legal stuff taken care of real quick. And might as well just keep us live for the time being, because we've got some fun stuff here.
Broadcasting from the Telegram News Studios at the Stockmeister Plaza, Southern Ohio's best music mix is on Mix 96. WKOV-FM, Oak Hill, Jackson, Wellston, and MacArthur, a Jackson County broadcasting station.
All right, here we go. This date in history.
Very good.
This date in 1957 that Jerry Lee Lewis secretly married his 13-year-old cousin, Myra Gale Brown.
Yeah, you know what? They didn't mind that down south. But as soon as he made his way over to Europe, they were not happy.
Well, nowadays it'd be considered weird, but back then it was also considered pretty weird.
Yeah.
That's the secrecy.
How about that?
This date in 1972. Speaking of musicians, James Brown was arrested in Knoxville, Tennessee for disorderly conduct.
Good God.
The charge was dropped after he threatened to sue the city for $1 million. Knoxville didn't want to see Mr. Dynamite go super bad, right. Plain and simple.
Go kiss myself.
This date in 2014, the world's first penile transplant took place.
Mm.
So I will use that word instead of the other word, just to be safe. So.
Good idea.
It was performed in Cape Town, South Africa. So I guess there was finally a cure to penile envy, I guess. Okay. So.
So.
Can I say so? This date in 2015, Playboy magazine published its last nude issue, featuring Pamela Anderson on the cover. Imagine that.
What year?
2015.
They don't.
I guess not. I don't know. I mean, I never was a big Playboy person. So.
I have never bought a Playboy in my life. So.
I bought a few back in high school.
Yeah.
And early college. And. Needless to say, I got caught. I came home one time. You know, I did the old classic. It's never get caught if I put it between my mattress.
Yeah, right.
You know?
Yeah.
I come home one afternoon, and it's the time when my mom has decided to clean my room for me.
Yeah.
My bed was made nicely, and there sitting in front of the pillow was my Playboy magazine with a note that said, "We'll talk later."
We'll talk later. That's right.
Needless to say, that was the last copy I ever bought. So, yeah. Of course, 2015 is also when my dad canceled his subscription, too. So. My dad never had a subscription to Playboy. My uncle, on the other hand, I think he had a couple. So, I don't know. This date in 2019, Greta Thunberg was named Time's 2019 Person of the Year. So, if you're mad at that one, you're probably furious about Taylor Swift being on the cover this year. So,
nah.
I don't know. So. Hey, this date in 1946, a six-block plot of Manhattan in New York was offered as a donation to be used as the world headquarters of the United Nations. The offer was accepted, and the rest, they say, is history. This date, 1951, Joe DiMaggio announced his retirement from baseball. 1961, Please, Mr. Postman by the Marvelettes.
Wait a minute.
Peaked at number
one.
Yep, 1967.
Wait, what year did you say that was?
1961.
61. And you know, the Beatles did it in, 64.
Yep.
Funny enough.
So, 61. 1967, the Concorde, the world's first supersonic airliner, was unveiled. Always wished I would have had the chance to see it fly. Never did get the chance to.
I do know some people who actually flew on the
Concorde. Oh, wow. Yeah. That would have been an experience. So. They said it wasn't quite the luxury and the experience that everybody thought it was going to be, apparently.
Right.
And that was another thing that kind of...
Of course, there are... the Concorde and the fact that it doesn't fly anymore. And,
yeah. It had, apparently, if I remember right, it landed a couple times in Columbus. I don't know if it was like for shows or what, but I did finally see one this summer when I was in New York City because I always wanted to see one because I always thought they were just amazing.
Yeah.
And I thought I was going to actually get to go on it and tour it, but it's on the Intrepid in New York City, the aircraft carrier display.
Okay.
And it's built... It's right there at the dock, but it's not on the aircraft carrier. It's on the dock, and it's a separate display, and it was closed that day because I guess there's no air circulation whatsoever in the thing. And, of course, it was the middle of July in the Concrete Village, so, like, we don't open it up during the summer because it's, like, 150
it's
degrees inside
there.
It. So.
Yeah.
And I guess it's a pretty small plane on the inside, too. So.
Yeah, I think so.
But 1967. 1975, first-class postage stamps went from 10 to 13 cents.
Those were the days.
Oh, to be considering, I think I paid, was it $11.75 for a book of stamps last time? I mean, I don't know how much it was.
Oh, I have no idea.
They don't put the prices on anymore. They just say forever.
Yeah.
Which is good, but man, I know it was a lot more expensive than I thought it was going to be. So.
Yes.
This date in 1980, Magnum PI premiered.
Ooh.
So, and all of us wanted to drive a little...
The red
small
Ferrari.
Ferrari and...
Yeah. Is that what it is? Ferrari or Lamborghini?
That's Ferrari, I think.
Okay. I can't remember.
Wear our flat-billed hats and...
Yeah.
Grow a mustache that would be to die for.
Yes.
For some reason, has all of a sudden come back in again, so...
Yeah. I'm not quite sure why.
So, let's see what else. 1981, Muhammad Ali fought his 61st and last fight. He lost to Trevor Burbick. The state 1982. Oh, Mickey, you're so fine. You're so fine. You love my mind. Hey, Mickey. Hey, Mickey. Yeah. By Tony Basil, peaked at number one. And for the rest of our lives, we've been going, who?
Who?
But that's okay. Everybody still knows that song.
That's right.
1990, Ivana and Donald Trump got a divorce after 12 years of marriage. Okay. So, but it was wonderful because they brought us Ivanka.
That's right.
So, yeah, it is what it is. 1992, A Few Good Men opened up in theaters. I want the truth.
You can't handle the truth.
Still one of the best scenes in the entire movie.
Yeah, absolutely. I don't know of any of the other scenes.
Yeah, I know,
I mean,
so.
I know that they're there.
Did you order the code red? So, it's a great movie. It really is. 2002, a judge awarded Pamela Anderson and ex-husband Tommy Lee $740,000 each in their court battle over the porn company and their infamous honeymoon sex tape.
Mm-hmm.
So, 2008, we were reminded of the word Ponzi scheme when Bernie Madoff was arrested and charged with securities fraud and $50 billion of Ponzi schemes. State in 2010, Good Charlotte, lead vocalist Joel Madden, wed fashion designer and actress Nicole Richie in Beverly Hills. 2017, State Senator Kirsten Gillibrand called for the resignation of President Donald Trump, given that 16 women accused him of sexual harassment. Which people were just like, you didn't know this about this beforehand?
This was not news.
You're surprised?
This was not news.
Yeah.
Yeah, I remember.
This date in 2017 also is when six wildfires in South Carolina covered an area larger than New York City and Boston combined. Mm-hmm. Remember those? Just hugging us.
Yeah.
It is National App Day.
App Day.
Yeah, so technically the holiday is celebrating the marvels of digital applications and technology. But if you think I'm not using it as an excuse to order mozzarella sticks, you're crazy. Just an appetizer.
That's a good one.
Appetizer days.
You know, nowadays, seriously, I ordered, you almost have to start doing some of these things on the app. You know, if you want discounts or things that used to be normal, you know, you're going to Subway, it's going to be a buy one, get one half off. You're going to, you know, Chipotle accumulates my stuff. Apparently, I order a lot of food on apps.
Yeah.
Ooh.
Hey, also, it is International Mountain Day.
Okay.
You see that mountain over there? One of these days, I'm going to climb that mountain. Sorry, I just had a little bit of Alabama flashback there. So
you made a mountain out of a molehill on that one, I think, Matt.
I know. Kaleidoscope Day is also today.
Kaleidoscope Day.
Yeah, you know, little funky things that you put up against your eye and spin around and get the, wow, man.
Psychedelic, dude.
Yeah. I'm assuming this is because Magnum P.I. premiered on this date in 1980. It's also Magnum P.I. Day.
Okay.
And it's National Noodle Ring Day.
What's a noodle ring?
I do not know, but it's National Noodle Ring Day, so we need to find a reason to celebrate it.
Okay.
So, yeah, that's your this date in history. And, hey, we're only 2 weeks away from Christmas, so we need to play some more Christmas music, and we have not broke this one out this year yet. How about the Chipmunks?
All
Chipmunk
right.
song.
All right.
Mix 96 FM.